at this silky male, 14 years old. The complaint is this eye ulcer. How long already this ulcer?
Oh, 1 week.
1 week.
But previously it lasted for, I think, around a month already.
Previously what?
Around about a month already.
The same eye?
Yeah, same eye.
And then the vet treated it?
Yeah, it was better. It got worsened only like last week. Yesterday she got them very bad. 2 days, 3 days ago.
So you can see the bulging of the basement membrane. That's the decimetocele. So this decimetocele is the bulging of the basement membrane coming out. This I can see. January 5th, 2016. This Silky Terrier has the eyelids stitched up for the last 10 days. What's the reason for it? So you continue. My assistant will continue the story.
Okay. So this is a Be Kind to Pets veterinary educational video sponsored by Topayo Vets. Here we have a 14-year-old male Silky Terrier. On 27 December 2015, 10 days ago, the owner came to Topayo Vets for a second opinion. His dog had a deep corneal ulcer in the right eye. On 27 November 2015, his vet had treated it 1 month ago, but the ulcer did not heal. His dog kept rubbing his right eye against the wall and the bed. The dog wore an e-collar, but he continued rubbing his eyes, deepening the ulcer. This condition is called deep ulcerative keratitis. His vet advised enucleation, which is the surgical removal of the eyeball. The owner inquired about alternative solution to save the eye. The eye had no intraocular infection. Therefore, the vet at Topayo Vets proposed tarsography with third eyelid flap, and this has been done.
Go.
So I've drawn an illustration to show the procedure. First, the suture goes through the stent and through the top eyelid into the third eyelid and down the bottom eyelid. On the second drawing, we can see that the suture goes through the bottom stent, and in the third picture, we can see that it goes back through the third eyelid and up through the top eyelid and through the top stent. The fourth picture, we can see that the suture is being tightened up, and in the fifth picture, the eyelid is securely closed.
Okay.
So the eye remains closed for the next 10 to 14 days to allow the ulcer to heal without irritation from dust, wind and sunlight. Antibiotic eye drops and painkillers are given inpatient for 10 to 14 days.
So it's a 5% isoflurane plus oxygen anesthesia. Then once the dog is down, you turn to the side. Okay, he cut the stint. This is a horizontal mattress suture. He needs to cut only certain parts, and then he will get. Then the thing can be torn. The below part. Below the stain taken out already. So clean up the eyes. Put eye drops and saline. Now we see the ulcer. You can see. Okay, open up the eyelids. We'll see how it looks like now. The dog is under gas so that it doesn't feel the pain. Almond was well, longer protection. And then painkillers for 4 days on, 4 days off. Ready? Let me focus on it. So you see the deep ulcer is healing. There is the blood vessel surrounding it. And there's no more hole. When you see the original image, you see the hole there, but not the scar tissue there, the white tissue on. He went to clean up.
小便也是，
它会叫。
它要清干净是吗？
啊，对。
Okay, that's a painkiller, 40 on, 40 off, antibiotics and eye drops, eye ointment. Then go home, then check in 14 days, should be a white scar. Now you can see very terrible.